those orange cheerleaders, they really look like they're getting into these cheers, having a fun time.
Valerie said a three-point lead does not really mean much in sports night. It just showed that the black picked up another point. Now it's only two. We've still got quite a few events to go tonight and many more tomorrow night. The tire pole is one of those events which is repeated every year because of its enormous popularity. As you can see, two tires are placed in the middle of the floor. Now, on each side of the gym are two lines, each for the black team and two lines for the orange team. And the tire pole is essentially self-descriptive. Two contestants run out, and each tries to pull the tire and or the other opponent over a line. And whoever gets the tire over the yellow line at which they're standing will win.
There's lots of seats over here.
And this is another event that's been organized by Mr. Ken Alston, who's a gym teacher here at Pensbury, and he's been at Pensbury for 18 years and has been co-director of Sports Night for 14 of those years, and he's responsible for putting together all these floor events. So Mr. Alston deserves a lot of thanks and a lot of recognition for this. These are really well-organized events, and everyone has a lot of fun doing them.
Yes, this is certainly one of the most successful he has organized. Contest. All that is required is that the tire is pulled over the green line.
This has really been a back and forth fight between the orange and the black, and each team gets 1 point on that.
Two orange victories there. They seem to be pulling out to an early lead.
Thank you.
quite a tussle.
The cheerleaders are all around trying to urge on their teammate. No victory yet.
That last one looked like a real team victory. These contestants are very evenly matched.
Finally, the black member pulls it out. Black wins the foot race on the front tire.
Needed both those wins. It seemed like they were quite a bit behind, but they could make it close. There's no telling who will win. It's two more victories for the black. Make six in a row for the black team. Looked like the Orange was going to walk away with the event in the early moments, but...
Looks like they're getting close now. It's going to be a... It's going to be a close...
Yeah!
today, and he's a black captain, and he's trying to urge on his team down there.
Quite a seesaw battle here. They had quite a string of victories there, so.
Ladies and gentlemen, an extremely close score from 16 to 14, and the winner is Orange.
What you see in front of you are the B and C period boys for the over-under relay. Now what this relay is it's five lines for each team. And essentially they have to pass a football back, one over the head and under the legs and so on. The last player must take the football, go up to the front and begin the whole process again.
And I think Black really wants his victory. Now they're down 7-10 and once again, down by 3 points, they want to pull out another victory and narrow that gap. And the cheering sections are trying to pull their groups together and urge them on to victory. The guys are lined up and getting some advice from team captains Frank Margolis and Roy Strandberg on the orange team.
You may notice that the first people in each line is a different color from the rest of the people in that line. The purpose of that is so that the referees can more easily keep track of the first player so they can tell when the line is finished, and that way they can more easily tell who won at the end. A lot of dexterity is required in this event. A fumble could be quite costly, so they have to make sure they hang on to the ball. It would appear from here that Orange is leading, although it's a close race.
Who's winning?
Let's go, Mark!
Looks like Black got the victory there.
It was a close race, but if it was a Black victory, it'll pull you within 2 points.
Our winner is Black.
By their phys ed teachers, including Mr. Ed Cochrane, Mr. George Canaris, Mr. Vic Napolitano, and of course Mr. Alston, who coordinated, co-coordinated the whole sports night along with Mrs. Cochrane. Mrs. Cochran's group doing the Morticia dance. Their captains are Michelle Kushner and Beth Saltzman, and look at those costumes.
But don't let the color fool you. This is an orange dance.
Michelle Kushner and Beth Saltzman did an outstanding job as captains, and their mothers also helped along. And special thanks goes to Jenny DiGilio, Julie Fowler, Cara Borkovitz, and Michelle Ledford, who also helped with the dance. And Mrs. Cochran says that despite the fact that the dresses are all black, she decided it would be a great idea for a dance.
Why,
course we're going to give it a shot. The Beep Area Transformers, which are also Mrs. Cochran's group, were captained by Yvonne Russinello and Marty Shank. And they did a great job. And look at those costumes out there with the boxes and the silver color. And special thanks also go out to Kim Hawes, Carol Giles, and Bonnie Root, who also helped with the dance. You can tell a lot of time and effort went into these costumes. Mrs. Cochran says that one of the hardest things about sports night is watching her two classes go against each other, knowing that one will win and one will lose, but she always knows that they're out there to have fun and do their best, and that's what makes it worth it to her.
As you can see, the costumes are quite a bit different from those of the other three dances. Should make it quite an interesting dance.
Transformers.
I'm amazed at that costume change. That was really great.
Yeah, it was a really remarkable dance. When you consider the theme of Transformers, it requires a lot of precision and synchronization, and they certainly accomplished that.
They also had the largest gym class, and it's really difficult to be coordinated with almost 90 people, but they did a great job of it. That's another tough one to call. I don't know which one I'd pick. Glad I'm not a judge.
Yeah, well, of course, the judges are from three separate schools, so they're going to be neutral, of course. Which is good, because it'd really be hard to be picking one over the other. Looks like we're going to get another cheer from the superheroes.
Well, nice smile on her face. She did a great job.
Data is going to tell you who the judges picked between the orange team Morticians and the black team Transformers. And the winner is...
Well, tonight, the orange team has picked up both girls' dances, which is certainly going to give them a lift going into tomorrow.
And the orange team is really elated over that. They knew that was a tough competition, and they're really glad to win it.
Ladies and gentlemen, an orange team cheer.
And here come the orange cheerleaders now. After pulling out that big victory, they should be really peppy and happy.
Valerie, you mentioned the acrobatics, but... really, the dance steps that they have to do are also quite synchronized.
It's really impressive. They put a lot of practice in, and it really shows.
Thank you.
huge Care Bears.
At this time, data is ready to disclose the team that has shown their outstanding ability for team organization.
Tonight, the cheering sections have been really together, and every team has come out onto the floor in a good order. That's mainly credit to the captains, who have really pulled their teams together and gotten everyone to do what they're supposed to do when they are allotted the time to do it.
Yes, it's really amazing when you consider how many people participate in sports night that they're actually able to get this thing off the ground, but they do it in quite fine fashion.
Now here's Dana to present the organization points.
Dana is ready to disclose the team that has shown their outstanding ability for team organization. And the winner is...
down this first night of sports night.
The boys in B and E take part in the football relay.
Well, the contestants coming out onto the floor now are for the final event tonight, the football relay. Looks like a must-win situation for Black. If they can pick up the point, they'll go in only down by 3, and they'll have an excellent chance to make up ground tomorrow. If Orange wins, they'll have a 5-point lead, which, at the way Orange is going, might almost seem insurmountable. So this relay might have a telling effect on what happens tomorrow and who eventually wins sports night.
But one good night can turn it around for either team, so... we won't know until tomorrow, even if Orange does win this race.
This relay, in theory, is very simple. Each team has 4 lines of 12 lined up on either side of the gym. And essentially what happened is the football is relayed back and forth, and it has to essentially go through the line. And the color that wins is the first one to get all its lines completed.
Tonight. sections realize what an important relay this is. They're already up on their feet and cheering for their teams. And the whistle hasn't been blown yet.
It's a very quick event. We'll soon be able to tell who's going to win. Should pump Black up for tomorrow's events.
And the winner is Black.
And the Black team is on its feet. They know that a 3-point lead is not too much in this sports night contest every year. It seems like a team can catch up from a deficit even greater than 3.
Yes, you remember it was Black who opened with the lead, so certainly if Orange could overcome their deficit, there's no reason that Black couldn't.
George Gamaris and Victor Maldonado.
they get ready to finish. Swing the cameras back around.
We have one more night of competition.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. Now have your attention, please.
We have one more night of competition before the winner will be declared. The points for cheering section and cheerleaders will be awarded then. As you can see, the score is orange, 12, and 9 for black. The captains are to be congratulated for a fine job.
Ladies and gentlemen, our alma mater.
Sports Night is all about, what you're hearing on the floor right now.